Hey friends, wanted to do a quick update on the listening practices that we have been encouraged and challenged to practice within our communities. And so wanted to give the quick few minute update on what that looked like for me. So with the listening prayer, with the Lectio Divina, and then with the aspect of communal reading of scripture, I put the three together for one of our young adult gatherings. We meet on Monday nights at our church, and we have people from 18 to 30. And we did all three in one night, which was really powerful for us. So we actually started with doing the communal reading of scripture, and we did it last Monday to kick off Holy Week. And we focused on Mark chapters 13 through 16. So we really looked at what the Passion Week and the Holy Week looked like for Jesus. I missed the assignment on the Exodus reading. But I'm glad we got to do the Mark reading, and it was really powerful to be able to read that out loud, and I could just sense as we were doing that, people were really engaging in this posture of allowing the Word to wash over them, and more than them just reading the Word, having the Word read them and kind of speak to where their hearts were at and prepare them for the movements of Holy Week. And got to hear some great insights from people during the group, after the group, of what that was like for them. secondly, we moved into a time of Lectio Divina, and we focused on Mark chapter 16, verses 1 through 8, kind of that scene of the two Marys and their friend Salome coming to the tomb, seeing that the tomb is empty. And it was really powerful to open up space for the Lord to speak to people, kind of hone in on a specific piece from that larger aspect of grouping of scripture that we read from. And so that was a really incredible moment for our group as well to hear what things were sticking out, what they meant out of the context of what we had just read from the entirety, and then what it looked like for them there within that specific eight verses. And then finally, we did the listening prayer. And what I had people do was take what the Lord was speaking to them about in the Lectio time, and then get in groupings and do some listening prayer throughout the week for one another and share that. And it's been really powerful to hear about the follow-up with people. It kind of turned into an accountability practice for some. And it's been really amazing to hear what this has looked like for people. The person that I partnered with, it was really neat to, in the middle of Holy Week and Passion Week, to be able to be in intercession and listening for one of my brothers in community, and I know it was powerful for others as well. So yeah, it was an amazing opportunity for us to just sit and listen and to really allow the Lord to do most of the speaking, even though most small group formats and most group formats in the church are all about us doing the speaking. It was really beautiful to have the Lord do the majority of the leading and do the majority of the speaking, and I think it's something that is not new to our community, but it is something that was deeply cherished, especially in the midst of this Holy Week. So I'm excited to hear from you guys on your experiences and what it looked like in your communities, and looking forward to chatting soon. Hope your Easters were great. Hope the Passion Week was beautiful, and we'll talk to you guys soon. Thanks.